Hey VC, what's up? It's me, yours truly. I am back to post a quick video here. Just a recent finds video. You know, stuff that's come in over the past couple weeks. Definitely quite a few things to show here, so I'll kind of jump right into it. It's been a really cool, you know, few weeks here because typically with working at both the shops, you know, I'll find a few things here and there that I want to grab, and you know, I'll take some stuff and I'll have some credit left there to just kind of builds over time or whatever. But it seems like the last 2 weeks, I've been using every single dime of my credit, plus having to kind of dip into my PayPal with stuff that I've sold on Discogs and everything to pick up all the stuff that I've wanted coming through the shop. So it's been quite a bit of stuff coming in over the past few weeks, which is always cool, you know, when you can stumble across a few things that you want. So let me just kind of dive right in. Two quick things I want to do before, though, is number one, I want to give a quick VCLT thanks. I've had this sitting right here in the last couple of videos. I forgot to do it, but and I won't do the addresses and everything here, but Jay lives up in Seattle here in the VC. He's kind of been following my channel for a little while. We kind of got into a quick chat. He's asked me about I guess it was a few months ago, I guess, the War on Drugs live album. And I'd seen it, but had not heard it yet. So he was nice enough to actually send me over a CD, a burnt copy of the album. So Jay, man, I really appreciate it. Really, I mean, thanks for taking the time to think about me on that. And I've definitely been wanting to check that album out because I debated on buying it a couple of times. So this will give me a chance to really kind of dive into it and listen to it and everything too. So yeah, just want you know I did get that, and thanks for sending it over, and really, really appreciate it, man. So thanks for thinking about me. Yeah, sorry, like I said, the last couple videos I've had it sitting right here and just kept forgetting to give you a thanks, so I appreciate it, man. The other thing I wanted to do too with another member here in the VC is that as you guys know, there are a number of people that are active in the VC that are actually musicians that put music out, which is always cool. You know, you have like Derek and a bunch of other people. Actually, I can sit here and name a few for days. But someone who's recently put out a new album, just kind of in the past week or two, couple weeks, is the one and only Bylli Crayone. And this is his new release of Toy Friend, which is kind of cool because it's his first Japanese pressing, as you can see by the obi there. And it's kind of cool when you order a copy, you know, you get an autographed 8x10 and all that good stuff. But yeah, you know, Billy's been doing music for quite some time now. I mean, he's been in kind of the 80s pop dance scene, and that's kind of been his area. And yeah, it's just got another great release. Like I said, it's really cool he does get, he did get his first Japanese pressing, because he has put out like three or four albums on vinyl, and I don't know how many on CD. So I mean, he has a nice little catalog that he's built up over the course of his career. But if you are an 80s pop dance fan, make sure you go kind of check this out. Matter of fact, I'm going to leave a link down below to ByllyCrayone.com, and you can go over there and check him out. But yeah, always great when one of our own here in the VC excuse me, is actually brave enough to put out some of their own music into the world. So cool stuff. So yeah, so Bylli, thanks for sending that over. I really appreciate getting a copy of that. And Jay, same to you, man. Thanks for sending it over as well. I really appreciate it. Can't wait to dive into that. So just kind of moving on to just recent finds. So some stuff I'll go into detail. Other things, you kind of know the album, so I'll just go right through. But still, one very exciting pickup for me here was Black Sabbath Master of Reality. A nice OG pressing, green label there. As you can see, in pretty darn good condition, because usually with these, you see, you know, all the white wear that usually takes place right around there. But yeah, absolute beautiful copy there. Vinyl in excellent plus condition. Did not have the poster in it, which kind of sucked, but I mean, hey, we'll stumble across one of those at some point in time, but nice to have a nice OG pressing of that. Crazy World of Arthur Brown, another great pickup here. Tone, you know, here in the VC, he actually showed a copy of this in a video just like a week or so ago, if even that long ago. And I made a comment how, yeah, it's a great album. I so need to get a copy of it. And sure as heck, the next time I pop into a record store, a very nice 1968 pressing just sitting there. you know, great all the way around. It has a little sticker kind of thing going on down there, but you know, I guess that's kind of one of the things that only anal people notice anyway. But but yeah, really, really great copy of that. And you know, kind of this, the legendary nature of this record and Fire and just all the other weird stuff that he did that was so groundbreaking in the shock rock genre. So very good addition there. And just in case you weren't aware that this had been released on vinyl, Violent Femmes, Add One Plus Up, 1981 through 1993. This is just their kind of a greatest hits album. I've had this CD forever, and it really kind of shows what makes vinyl cool, because like, I had the CD forever, listened to it I don't know how many times, but just walking into the store and seeing this 12 by 12 sitting on the shelf, it's just like, that's what makes vinyl cool. I mean, it just took the album to another level just by getting the nice big version, if you will. So great 2LP set there, great reissue. And a band that's fairly new to me, this is Gojira. Heard the name a number of times, but never actually really heard their stuff or checked them out. And really, really dug this album. I mean, oh my gosh. A couple of customers that came in and picked it up were just talking so highly of it, I just had to check it out, and it's freaking awesome. The best way I could describe this album, I mean, I think maybe their others might sound a little different, but specifically talking about this album, is this is Sepultura meets Nickelback. Okay? And usually when you say, I mean, let's say when you say Nickelback, there's a lot of people that automatically want to slam and blah blah blah. And I'm not even necessarily talking about anything that might be popish Nickelback. But the one thing that I always say about Nickelback that you cannot deny, whether you like their music or not, like their songs or not, you know, all the type of stuff, you cannot deny that that band can blow your hair back as hard as any band out there. When it comes to just power in your face rock, Nickelback is as hard as any band out there. And laugh if you want, but if you really go dig into their stuff, those boys can rock hard. And so what I'm trying to say is with this album, you get that hard in your face. The rock parts of the album are very hard in your face. And then the all of the other metal elements of the album is very much Roots, Bloody Roots type of rhythmic, just like tribal Sepultura. And then this album just freaking kicks you, man. It's just a fantastic album. So maybe people don't like the way I define that, but hey, when a band kicks you in the right place, it kicks you in the right place, whether you like their music or not. So great album there. Phil Collins, the singles, just kind of a 2LP greatest hits. You know, In the Air of the Night, I Missed Again, Groovy Kind of Love, Against All Odds, just all the hits you would expect from Phil Collins. True Colors, and some of his later kind of hits too, with things like Can't Stop Loving You, which is one of my favorite songs by Phil Collins. Dance Into the Light, all that great stuff. So very, very nice 2LP set there. Exhorter there. Slaughter in the Vatican, again, just kind of straight up metal here. So I'm not really a heck of a lot to say about that, just great metal, plain and simple. Very much more on the thrash side, not death metal or anything of that nature, but much more thrash. And haven't listened to this all the way through yet, but this is Slipknot, We Are Not Your Kind. I've only listened like two or three songs off of this so far, but you know, always love Slipknot. Not to mention, I wanted to go ahead and pick it up because it seems like all their stuff just seems to kind of get out of price range pretty fast anyway. So, looking forward to kind of diving into their new one. And Motley Crue's Greatest Hits. And this is a Walmart exclusive. Oh my God, he bought another one. Yeah, so Walmart exclusive of, I think this was originally with the red cover one. I think that was a 2000 release. But yeah, it's just their greatest hits. I mean, there's no new tracks or anything added. It's the exact same as the 2000 press that I have. But again, just I'm really kind of digging getting into these Walmart exclusives. So I went ahead and picked up this copy, and yeah, which is really so weird too, because up until about the last 12 months, I despised colored vinyl and I despised bootlegs. Did not want either if I could ever avoid it. And just over the past 10 to 12 months, I'm like seeking out colored vinyl and bootlegs of things, which is just such a big change for me. But yeah, awesome pressing here, and I'll be curious to see if this sounds better than the original pressing that I have, or just as good. Next here, we have a Grin All Out from 1973. And this is just kind of some early, I'm trying to hold it low so the light doesn't adjust too much. Some early Neil Lofgren's, again from 1973. I really didn't get into Neil's very much until probably really 8 or 9 years ago, so fairly recently. And just so fell in love with his live album, which is one of my favorite live albums of all time. But yeah, so it's kind of cool just to catch up on some of his older stuff that I wasn't as familiar with. You know, he's a heck of a guitar player too, which is pretty awesome. But so yeah, that was a kind of a new discovery for me there. The next one here, I'm just going to show both of these kind of at the same time. We got Airborne, and you got Bone Shaker and Breaking Out of Hell. And as you can see by the hype stickers there, this is a effing rock and roll record, and no ballads, no bullshit. And the easiest way to describe Airborne, and I've liked them for quite some time. I've had one of their other records, but you know, finally picked up a couple of others here. But easiest way to describe them, and this is a fake story, but easiest way to describe them is, okay, one of the band members here was working at a recording studio. Happened to be the same recording studio where AC/DC recorded their albums. AC/DC would write songs, some songs they kept for the albums, other songs AC/DC would ball up and throw in the garbage. Well, while cleaning up at night, he was stealing the songs out of the garbage, taking them home, rehearsing them, and then he and his band went out and they laid all those songs down and put out a couple albums. If that were a real story, and it's not, if that were a real story, that would completely and totally coincide with what Airborne sounds like and just what their albums are like. They are pure AC/DC up and down on pretty much every single album. I mean, they're not covering a bunch of AC/DC songs here or anything like that, but I still almost bet that if AC/DC decided to file a lawsuit and their lawsuit claim, "You're stealing our style," the judge might actually give AC/DC the case, because it's just that ridiculous. But yeah, again, I'm kind of just being silly with all of that. But in all seriousness, though, if you are an AC/DC fan, I would almost find it impossible that you would not like Airborne. I really would. And if you haven't heard of them before, the first song I recommend checking out, which is not on those two albums, it's on their, the other album I got, the earlier one. Why am I going brain dead? What's Eating You? That would be the first song I recommend checking out. And if you dig that, dive into the rest of their catalog. All right, so then this was one of the pieces that came into the shop that put me over my credit limit, but I could not resist. This was Mark Cohen. This is self-titled from 1991. You can see a nice Mo-Fi pressing there. Kind of nice too, because you know, Bylli over at Riverbend Records, he actually kind of held it off to the side. I think he knew it was something I wanted, so he, you know, kind of gave me a shot to kind of come in and grab it, which was very, very awesome. But yeah, this has been on my want list for quite some time, and it's really one of those hard ones because it's an early 90s record. They haven't reissued it. The, like, regular, if you will, original pressings cost the exact same as the rare Mo-Fi pressings, so it's just a hard album to come across, period. So yeah, to get a just beautiful near mint Mo-Fi copy of that was just like wow, like there's no way I could pass that up. So a fantastic album. Of course, it has the gigantic hit Walking in Memphis, which is you know, definitely the song that kind of put him on the map. And it's kind of interesting too, just take a quick 20 seconds here, because I was watching them do an interview not too long ago, and he was talking about how this was like his third album or something like that. Anyway, the record label was saying, hey, you got to come up with something big here. We're going to have to drop you because your first albums didn't do that well, blah, blah, blah. And so he kind of just decided to leave his family for a while and just kind of go out and search for inspiration. And so he went to Memphis. So when you listen to the lyrics in that song, you know, put on my blue suede shoes, boarded the plane, touched down in the land of the Delta blues in the middle of pouring rain. You know, and just all the stuff he talks about walking in Memphis. Muriel plays piano every night in the Hollywood. She asked me if I, you know, and she said, tell me if you're a Christian. And I said, ma'am, I am tonight. And so you listen to all these lyrics throughout the course of the song, and it sounds like he's talking about just some deep, moving experience about the power of Memphis and the musical history, and he's using these metaphors and everything. And actually, he's not. He is talking about, like, literally what took place on his trip to Memphis. Like none of the stuff he talked about was really, well, maybe they saw the ghost of Elvis, but even with all that stuff, it wasn't metaphors. It was like, I did go down and see Muriel at the Hollywood. She did ask me to come up and do a number with her. She did ask me if I was a Christian, and I told her, hey, I am tonight. And like, it was like, so you spend all this time growing up with these great songs, and you know, you try to get all, you know, smarty, if you will, cerebral, however you want to put it, about it, by thinking, oh, it's so deep and I get where he's coming from. And the dude's just being plain and simple and straightforward and just as literal as you could possibly be. And the more he talked about that, it just absolutely blew my mind. It was so cool. But anyway, great album, definitely a grail for me from that standpoint. So happy to have that. Next one here, I wasn't as familiar with this. I was just introduced to this a week ago. The Proto Men, and this is The Cover Up. Now again, I don't know all the details behind it. From what little I was told, now I listened to it all the way through, but from what I was told is that this was an album by like this group or whatever. It was kind of like a soundtrack for a movie that had never been made. Like the movie never really existed. There's like all this type of stuff behind it. But it's basically just covers of a lot of great songs that the Proto Men did. So Because the Night, you know, of course, Bruce Springsteen and Patti Smith, Prince of the Universe, Mr. Roboto, No Easy Way Out, In the Air of the Night, Total Eclipse of the Heart, The Trooper, you know, just Silent Running, Danger Zone, on and on and on. So a lot of great covers that they do. Now, if you follow the movie or the series Cobra Kai, In the Air of the Night, their version was featured in Cobra Kai. And it's really kind of funny because if you look at that hype sticker, if I can get it over there, you know, basically what that says right there is includes In the Air of the Night featured in the hit karate show Snake Gang. And then right below, which of course is Cobra Kai, but then it goes right below, it says, sorry, we couldn't get the official licensing for it. So I can't say the rest of it. So how cool of a hype sticker is that? Since they couldn't get the licensing to put Cobra Kai, they put featured in the snake with the movie with the Snake Gang, which is just great. But a very fun album to listen to. It really just kind of plays like an 80s greatest hits kind of thing. But moving right along, I'm trying to pick it up a little bit here. Heart by Eric Church. This is his new release. It's kind of a three-parter too. You know, one of my favorite modern country fans. There was Heart, there was Soul, and then if you were part of whatever the fan club was or whatever, there was kind of one in the middle that was And, which from what I understand is like a very, very hard one, an expensive one to get now. But it was kind of Heart and Soul. But yeah, another great album, great country artist. Sturgill Simpson, another really good album here. Meta Modern Sounds in Country Music. This is basically country music and a country music / psychedelic album is what it boils down to. And some stuff is just straight up country, and then some stuff just feels almost straight up psych type of stuff. But one of the main things that caught me on it was a cover of When in Rome's The Promise that he did. It's a fantastic cover on this, so great album there. non-valuable, I'm not going to say grail, but a album I've been searching for a long, long time. Again, grail status can be about rarity, grail status can be about value, and sometimes it just comes down to the search, because this is just a basic $8 album. But the length of time that I have been looking for a nice copy of this that just did not have a ton of ring wear all around it has been a couple of years in the making. And you stumble across copies all the time, but again, finding a nice one has just been a very hard thing for me. So The Average White Band, Cut the Cake, really, really great album there. Funk, kind of soul album. If you listen to the first songs on here, Cut the Cake and Schoolboy Crush, you hear note for note samples that Too Short and so many other hip hop artists have used, and just a lot of people probably had just no idea that it was samples from The Average White Band. But yeah, so happy to finally get a copy of that album. Definitely one of my biggest under $10 albums that I've been looking for quite some time. The next one here was kind of a fun one I just had to pick up. Is it Kelis, or is it pronounced Kelis? Actually, I'm not 100% sure. I never thought about it just this moment. This is Tasty. And the funny thing about this is I was pricing some stuff the other day and found this album. And I walked up to the guys at the front desk and I saw this cover on the back. And I started kind of making a joke. And I was like, man, that'd be the perfect cover for like the Milkshake song. I started kind of singing it and dancing around and acting silly or whatever. And they were like, yeah, I just know. We had like a little good time with it. Then I came back, started looking at it, and I'm like, wait a minute. She is the one that sings the Milkshake song. So, yeah, you know, just sometimes you pick things up just because it's fun. I mean, that is kind of a fun song to have anyway. But yeah, I had no idea before I was making all these jokes about that should be the Milkshake cover album. Sure as crap, it is. Kenny Rogers, 21 Number Ones, just kind of a greatest hits. So fantastic album there, you know, all of his hits, you know, The Gambler, Lady, you know, all that good stuff. My favorite song by him though, which of course is Love Will Turn You Around, my favorite Kenny track of all time, and of course that's on here, so great stuff. There are just kind of like regular US pressings, and there's also a Walmart exclusive on like a goldish colored vinyl out there as well. More great additions to the hip hop collection, which is EPMD Back in Business. Just one more business album. Just still working on trying to pick up all of their stuff. You know, not the easy stuff to find all the time, but EPMD is definitely one of my favorite duos. Yeah, so great stuff there. Nice 2LP set. Some more great additions to the metal collection, which is Game Over. Burst Into the Quiet. It's a great album by them. It's kind of some nice thrash stuff right there, which is awesome. And a beautiful original pressing of Johnny's Cash at San Quentin. Just absolute near mint in shrink and everything. So beautiful, beautiful copy of that. And this next one here, I got to give a shout out to L. Andrews. You know, he does a lot of awesome Blue Note videos. He'll do like different, like the 400 series and all that type of stuff, 4000 series or whatever. And he showed this album in a video. And for some reason, just the way he was talking about this one made me have to go check it out, because I had never heard it before. And I'm so glad I did, because it is a slamming jazz album. Dexter Gordon, One Flight Up, said he was just kind of going on. And really, he was going on about one song for, and just something about what he was saying, it just caught me. And so I went and checked it out, and then lucky enough, was able to pick up a nice Tone Poet copy, which of course are fabulous pressings of that. But this is a killer jazz album, oh my gosh. Dexter was killing it on this one. So wonderful pickup. Just got there not too long ago. I've already listened to it 3 times. I mean, it's just awesome. And a little Bruno Mars. Found this so cheap and near mint condition. It's only a few bucks. So I was like, yeah, let me go ahead and put it in the collection. And the thing I'll say about Bruno, I'm not a gigantic fan of his. I mean, I like two or three songs on this, which are, you know, kind of fun. But for the most part, overall, with his catalog, I'm not really a gigantic fan. But the one thing I am a fan of, and one of the reasons why I will support him, is because I love the way that he brings the old nature and feel of kind of celebration back to R&B music. Kind of dance celebration elements of R&B. And he's doing it as much as any artist right now, which I think is just, even though I don't like a lot of his songs, I love that he's doing that. And so, you know, I'll still support him a little bit on those levels. You know, because when I think about that element, it's usually kind of like I'm going back to Sly and the Family Stone, and, you know, kind of even like some early Cool in the Gang and stuff like that, when it was still was about kind of like an uplifting type of feeling that was being put into the music. So anyway, moving right along, Al Green's Greatest Hits. As you can see there, another nice OG pressing, still in shrink, which is kind of cool. Don't stumble across those too often. I still got the original kind of sticker from the whatever store that was. So that was kind of neat. And the last two, got a little Melody here. Again, nothing kind of gigantic, but it's just kind of, she's one of those folk artists that I tend to dig a good chunk of her stuff. This is Gather Me. So nice little folk piece there. And last but not least, got Black Ivory. This is Feel It. Mid-70s kind of R&B. Nothing really here that kind of goes on the funk. This kind of goes more towards the smooth, kind of really soft, the Delphonics type of R&B. And just another really, really, really cool album there. So, whew. So there you go, VC. Like I said, quite a bit of stuff that kind of came in. A lot of great stuff I was really happy to add to my collection. And as always, let me know what you think. And we will talk to you soon. All right, take care, guys.